question.
No, I'm just saying, but I'm saying in the hadith,
the
same.
The first talking about the specific situation, the testimony of if there's a specific situation. So you bring two witnesses, two women, yep, and one man.
So okay, in terms of rape, you need four witnesses, is that right? Is that also the rape of a man?
For rape, no.
You don't need four, just two.
Yeah, the school has mentioned, if a woman said that someone raped her, yep, and there's a proof for it.
What proof? Her word, her testimony.
Yeah, but even in this country, your word is not proof.
Well, because in the evidence, but in the Quran, that's what I'm saying. There was
No. But what I was going to say also, you know you're God's punishing woman when they give birth.
I'm not talking about my God, I'm asking you, so 2282, okay, what
bro,
does
bro,
it say?
Remember, you're not a Christian, you're a person of bad liquor of the Islamic haters.
Okay, so
I know, follow the camera please, you are no trade Islam.
I'm just going to point out that in the hadith, you're the same person,
but I'm talking about the verse.
I'm deficient, it's all right.
No, you're not deficient.
I'm joking, I'm
joking. Because Aisha's better than me, she's a woman.
So is her...
The prophet
said this is because of the deficiency of a woman's mind.
That's not the hadith. Why are you misquoting the hadith?
Narrated by Abu Sa'id.
That's not the whole full hadith.
The prophet said, isn't the witness of a woman equal to that half of that of a man? The women said yes. He said, meaning the prophet, this is because of the deficiency of a woman's mind. So when I asked you, the verse doesn't say deficient, but the hadith, prophet says.
The hadith clearly explained, deficiency doesn't mean they're dumb or stupid.
No, deficiency means less than.
No.
Lacking. Yes, in English.
Deficiency of the mind. Lacking.
In English, does Prophet Muhammad speak English?
Might say deficiency of the mind.
No. She said in English. Look, paper boy, I know you don't want her to become Muslim.
I'm just clarifying.
So,
I wouldn't become Muslim.
I understand that. Of course.
Yes, of course I am. I'm not asking to become a Muslim.
Okay, excuse me.
No, I'm asking.
You have a razor, by the way. You have a razor, by the way.
Right.
No, sorry. You have a razor, by the way.
Why?
Because you ordered to shave her head off.
And what?
You ordered to shave her head off.
Really?
In the Bible.
Bring out the verse.
Is it in the
Bring out the verse, because the verse is going to refute him. I want him to read it. The verse refutes him. The verse. Oh, now no one wants the verse now. No one wants the verse
in the church, of course in the church.
Bring out the verse. The verse will refute you.
Read it. Would you shave her head off?
Read it. Because it says the woman's hair is her covering. So it says this is not what you have to do. That's what I'm saying. Read the verse. Read it. Read it.
Get the verse, please.
Read the whole verse.
I never see the biggest liar like that.
Thank you. Read the verse.
Okay, no. Can I speak to her?
She asked a question. Some minutes for her.
She was talking about... He asked me a question.
I remember, the head of every woman is a man. So that's why he wants to speak. Because she's lesser than you, of course.
You asked me about that verse.
You know, innit?
I know that Jesus is the head of man.
The man's head of every woman.
Yes.
So you're lesser than him.
I'm listening to him.
No, you're lesser than him. Jesus said, for every woman.
What happened to the shaving of the head?
Can I speak now? Because two people speak at the same time.
Okay, I'd like to just ask about two.
For every woman, doesn't look covered.
Read the whole verse. Read the whole thing.
Can we do 282?
No, start from before.
Can we move
around? Can you speak to him? You don't have to follow him.
Can you quote for me?
The hadith, I'm going to scan it.
No, the verse. Surah 2, 282.
The surah talking about specific matter.
It's a legal matter.
Okay. You bring a woman, you bring two witnesses for man. Yeah. If there is no man, you bring two women and one man. Okay? But, so, the hadith of Prophet Muhammad said, the word that is being used as deficient doesn't mean stupid. Because the hadith explained. He said, means when there's two witnesses, a man, the testimony is equal to two women.
Yes.
Okay? That specific matter. Okay?
And then he says, because a woman is deficient. No, that's not the hadith.
The hadith says.
It was narrated by Abu Sa'id.
That's English. The hadith said, the hadith explained
in
after.
In Arabic, what did he say?
That's what I'm saying. The hadith said, Prophet said, you are deficient because of. Your testimony is equal to one man. two women.
I understand the concept. I'm asking why. If God created man and women equal.
I understand that. It's a specific issue related to the verse. Okay?
So they're talking about partnership.
Okay.
I've never seen those who have shortcoming in mind and religion controlling those who have sound minds other than you. She said, O Messenger of Allah, what is the shortcoming in mind and religion? So it's not deficiency, it's shortcoming.
Shortcomings.
But that also
that's
means
it.
Less
that's
than. Like
no.
a less.
Okay,
and
explain.
And it's a hell full of women.
No, explain. No, no. There's more women.
Remember, that's the second point. That's
second point.
Yeah.
Yeah, remember. Remember, she's not to jump in.
Offended.
Can you deal with one point?
Yes, okay. Of course.
So this, anyway, thank you very much for helping us. It's a good translation, this one.
Okay, shortcoming.
It's not happy. Look, hatred for Islam. Hatred. He will kill us, you know, if he's allowed to kill Muslims. We're lying. Go on. No, he's
so,
not.
No,
he's
no.
Not.
So now, instead of deficiency, it's a
it's
shortcoming.
Shortcomings, yes.
Okay,
that's a good one.
So shortcoming is still a less than. And so if something's perfect or if something's good and something there's a shortcoming, it means it doesn't reach it.
No, it doesn't mean
and
all the
we
time.
Know we can. Like infer from that it's two women.
Are you
so
asking me?
Or
you're asking yourself.
I'm asking you.
Yeah,
can
you
we? I'm asking
them.
You. Can
let
we?
Me
you,
let me
no,
answer.
No, I'm
remember
still
the question. Not
you haven't
talking.
Answered me. You've changed the word deficiency to shortcoming.
No, I didn't take
no,
it.
No, 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 that's fine. And yeah, what I'm saying.
What's the point?
Well, like to, oh, sorry, is it my deficiency that makes you question?
No, because
I asked
you're babbling on, I don't understand.
I'm not babbling. Yeah.
He's saying it's well, not shortcoming deficiency.
I don't follow English.
But if you allow me to finish.
Okay, then finish.
Okay, so the hadith explained.
Right.
He says the reason being because of your shortcomings in religion.
Yes.
And because of the two testaments.
Okay.
However, there is some situation when a woman testimony is equal to four men testimony.
And what are those situations?
Okay, situation. If example me, I accuse a woman
yes.
to commit fornication.
Yes.
Now, if I bring three witnesses,
yep.
three men, the judge will accept her testimony and guess us and will be lashed.
Okay.
So now, how come no one speaks about this one?
I don't know. I've
okay.
Never
so
heard
therefore,
of it.
Therefore, in Islam, we have to understand.
Is that Sharia?
Sharia, yes. Yeah. Sure. In Islam, we believe because there's some issues which call branches issues.
Sorry.
Branches. Yeah, they're secondary.
Like on a tree, branches.
Yeah, secondary. So we come from the angle that Allah is the most high, the most
yes,
wise.
And He created us equal.
No, without any doubt. Prophet Muhammad said, man is equal to every woman.
Yes.
But in the Bible, he doesn't believe that.
No, but I'm saying that 2 2 8 2.
No, no, it's not. Because what you have to understand, what is wisdom? Wisdom. To put
the knowledge of good and evil and the fear of it. I was quoting the Bible. Sorry.
Wisdom to put everything in its proper places. You understand?
Okay.
You with me? So there's some situation when the equal or when the testimony of one woman is equal to two men or three men. You understand? So now what I would say to you, as mentioned before, so now also we know that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned the hadith because it's more about Jahannam. There's more women. Also in the hadith, there's more women in paradise than a man.
Oh, so there are just more women in general.
There's more women. Okay, no. Because why? Okay, if you're...
Maybe men live longer.
Because, no, woman. No, it's not hurry. It's not hurry, it's more. Okay.
And
now,
can I make a point now?
Let me finish my point.
But it's a very long point.
Yeah, but are you asking me a question, are you?
No, you're... No, he's asking rhetorical questions.
Yeah, no,
I really am.
So
I'm
let me finish. My point here now, what I don't like hypocrisy.
Yeah.
Okay. If I said to you, he's the head of you.
Yes.
What does it mean?
It means he's my husband.
No, it doesn't mean that
or
your husband.
Or he's someone in the church.
He's in charge of you.
In the church, I'm
okay.
saying.
When Jesus said, Jesus is the head of every man, what
yes.
does it mean?
It means he's in charge.
In charge, doesn't mean husband.
No, in charge.
Okay,
yeah,
so
okay, we agree.
Okay, now you're in charge. So when he said every man is
he
the head
say
of every
man. He was talking to,
get
who
the Bible.
Did?
Jesus said that.
Every man.
He said,
a Muslim
he said
man would
the,
be
said
in
God.
The head of me.
No. Of course, about the Bible, Christians.
He's gonna get it.
Bro.
It's about believing.
Bro.
Isn't it talking about amongst Christians the man?
I have two disagreements. Anyway. So now.
No, it's not.
Hey. For the husband is the head of the wife.
Yes, the
even
husband.
As, no, there's
not
another
all
one.
Men.
No, there's another one. When the father is the Jesus, the God.
I said that.
No, there's another one. Which
okay.
God is the head of every.
Christ is the head of the church.
No, before
which
that, no. Before that, God is the head of Jesus.
Yes.
Jesus
the
is
father,
the head of
not God.
The father. Yes, that is the term. The father is the head of what? Jesus. So there's hierarchy. A man is the head of what? Of woman.
Really?
So man is bigger than woman.
Do you know what?
Higher than
woman. Do you know what? Yeah. It also shows that there's difference.
Yeah, 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 of course. Jesus, sorry. There's difference. Also, there is a man here.
Every woman is man.
But I want you to realize the head of every man. I want you to realize the head of every man is a Christ. And the head of woman is man.
Yeah, not every man. Not I don't have to listen to all men.
I didn't ask you that.
No, no,
he's
I
a man.
Said that. I didn't ask you. I'm telling you.
No, no, but Jesus said, Jesus
said all men are headed by Christ, and the head of every woman is man.
He is a man.
Not man.
So there's a hierarchy. But he said,
I'm making that distinction because you seem to think that I should listen to a man just because he's a man.
No, yes, no, yes, yes, that's what, yes, that's what he said.
Husband.
That's what he said. Do you accept
right,
that?
In the other
you accept that? Do you, are you feminist, by the way?
Huh? For
course,
the believers.
I'm not looking for the Muslims, am I? It's a Bible.
Well, I don't know.
But
you're
you
a man
as a Christian,
and you're me
you
up
are
and
higher than her.
You're doing it because you're male.
He believes that. You know that. You know that. You know that. No, no, but you're.
It's talking about the household.
No, 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 no.
That's why I said it's talking about the
believers. There's another passage, another one. Are you not familiar with the Bible?
I said the believers.
It's man higher than man. It's man higher than woman.
No, 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 no.
It's man higher than woman.
There's another one. Here, read it.
Oh, now he's discussing with me. No, no, I'm not involved.
No,
khalas. You see? No, because when I'm involved,
he's scared. He's scared. That's what
I'm about. Okay. Do you want me to get? Would you like me to get involved?
So no, that's it.
Okay. So it's just that if God created man and women equal,
I'll get involved.
Generally speaking, yeah. Generally speaking.
Well, in the beginning, Adam and Eve equal.
No, but you don't believe that as a Christian.
I believe Adam and Eve were equal.
But are you aware that the reason?
No, I haven't finished my point. So my point is, if they are equal, then I don't understand why certain circumstances. I understand they have different responsibilities. Different roles in the family. But I don't know why in a court of law, God's law, they would be treated unequally. I think that's contradictory to God's central message of humankind.
No, it's not.
Equal.
It's not because God mentioned the reason. No, no, God. Look, we're speaking to him. We speak.
I thought you were involved.
I thought you were not involved. Are you involved or not?
If you want me to get.
Are you involved or not?
You want me to get.
No, no, are you involved or not?
Okay, yeah.
So, no, no, no. Do you accept? Look, hypocrisy. And guess him, he pulls back. When something he fixed for him, he comes in. That's
no, because before when I wanted
anyway,
to get involved, anyway, they said don't get
anyway,
involved.
Well, well, my point here is that you keep asking questions, and you already Allah mentioned the reason being for the situation. In order for the woman, if she forgets, she will remind the other woman. You understand? So Allah mentioned the reason for that. However,
you didn't tell me that.
Yeah, Allah mentioned the reason that. It's not because we treat them like they're nothing. Because we know one of the great scholars, I mentioned that to you before, one of the great scholars which the companions, Prophet Muhammad's companions used to refer to, what's her name? One of the Prophet Muhammad's companions, female.
Islamic scholar.
Aisha. So he knows. So he knows that we don't mistreat women. He knows.
But can he name a female scholar that never slept with the Prophet? Because we have female prophets in the Bible. He's saying she's a scholar, so therefore, because she's a woman, it's some sort of. Exactly.
No, I'm
but
sure
this is the
what. No, no, this is the point.
That she happened to be his wife,
just,
I think
just
is
said
the point.
We've got female prophets in the Bible.
Yes,
which one?
Esther.
Female prophets in the Bible.
Esther.
Some of Ibn Kathir's
Esther, the book of Esther.
What are you talking about?
What's he talking about?
Esther, no, no, no.
She's a female prophet.
What are you talking about?
You said you have a female
scholar. We've got a female prophet.
What was your point about having a female scholar?
No, I'm sure now that. No, I'm sure now that in Islam, women doesn't mean they are stupid or something.
No, I don't think so.
No, I'm showing you because what you lot do.
So my point was.
I'm not finished my point.
I'm just a me. I'm not a you. Go
on.
You just come from prayer.
Allah,
you should be so calm.
Allah. My point was to her that in Islam we don't accept women or we don't believe women is like nothing.
Unless you're a judge. And
no, no, no.
Even
if you're in charge doesn't mean you should oppress her because.
No, I mean a judge. Like
you know, even if you're a judge, you should not oppress
her.
It's not because why? Sometimes a woman's statement is equal to free men.
Yeah, yeah, but I didn't know
that's
about
what I'm
that.
Saying. So how come you don't do
that? Is that why in the Quran? I'm asking you. Is it in the Quran?
It's in the Quran. You have to be witnesses,
okay.
Yeah.
Go look for that.
Yes, in the Quran.
So
it's a note. So I
okay. You
know,
you were talking about. That's what I told you. Make your point.
My point was about showing her the woman has highest in Islam. Like one of the Muslim scholars, Ibn Taymiyyah, his teacher was a woman. Okay. Understand? But the great companions and the great scholars, the teacher was woman. So okay. To show you that in Islam also women are allowed to speak in the mosque. But you're not allowed to speak in church.
Yes, I am.
Okay, let me ask you a question.
Unless let him get that's right. To be silent.
Women are allowed to speak.
Now, let me ask
unless
you a question.
Unless I'm asked so to be quiet.
In this Let a woman, scripture. Because you become feminist today.
No,
let
I'm not a feminist.
Let a woman learn quietly with all submissiveness.
Right.
But how come men should not do that?
What about when they're teaching?
Okay, no. I do not permit.
Can they teach less?
Listen. I do not permit a woman to teach. To do what?
To teach. In the church.
You don't know how to teach.
Wait.
Woman is allowed to teach in the mosque. How come you? You tell me go teach you Ikili.
Have you got a lot of them?
So you believe?
No. You teach go Ikili.
Women are able to teach.
No. Now they want me. They don't want me. You see what they do?
I've got one more question.
Her point was that I don't accept or something like that. God who created us equally.
No, I'm saying it seems like God created equally in the Quran and the Bible. And then the Quran goes on to say, except this certain situation.
The Bible says that as well.
So is the Bible. That's not equality. That's not saying if I'm being
prosecuted. You don't know how to teach.
No. But I can teach at home.
You're not equal with a man. You're not equal with a man. Men's allowed to teach in the church. Yeah. You're not allowed to teach.
But imams are not women.
No. I'm not talking about imam. Teacher.
Exactly.
I'm talking about teacher.
So, yes. No, bro. You see?
So you're talking about the Bible.
Teacher. No.
So there's Paul is talking and about priests.
No, it's not a priest.
No, wait.
I'll show you. Let me finish my point.
No, because you're misquoting and mischaracterizing the Bible.
The
Bible is talking about in black being preachers or bishops or whatever.
Who doesn't say that?
If the Bible is written
for Christians. No, who doesn't say that?
It's the Christians that interpret the Bible.
No, don't put words.
A Muslim cannot interpret the Bible for
you. No, Christians differ. The Christians differ.
Exactly.
Exactly.
Because I'm saying to you, some people disagree that women cannot become bishops, but some will say this verse says women can become bishops. But he has admitted that women cannot be, he doesn't agree women can be imams.
So
Adam,
let us read the passage, let us read scripture. In the Quran or the Hadith does not say women should listen and be
deficient.
No, submissive, not deficient.
Exactly.
You are deficient, we're deficient.
Listen,
let me finish. Let me say deficient.
Let me finish for 10 minutes. Okay.
Because you keep cutting me for the last 10 minutes.
Okay.
The passage is clear. Let a woman learn quietly. With all submissiveness. Okay, I do not permit a woman to teach, to exercise authority over a man. Rather, she is to remain quiet. For Adam was from the first, then Eve. And Adam was not deceived, but a woman was what? Deceived.
Adam was deceived. He ate the apple.
Paul is a liar then.
No, he ate the apple.
Paul said he was not.
He was deceived by Eve.
Wait.
So the Bible's lying.
Paul was lying. No. He said he wasn't.
I'm allowed to interpret it how I want.
You see, look at his lies. He said, let him finish, then I can sleep.
What did she say?
She said,
look at the double standard. You want to say something?
Yes.
No, listen carefully.
Yes.
The woman came to me, she wants to speak to me.
Yeah.
Okay?
Alright, that's fine.
No, okay. But when, no. Wait!
Every time, let me finish. What? When am I going to get to speak?
When he finishes,
let me make my statement, then he replies. Let me make. He's been speaking for 10 minutes.
And
he said,
you came.
No. He said, let me. He gave me his phone and said, I should explain.
He never called you.
You see? He's debating everyone. This time, don't run. I don't have to prove myself to you, because alhamdulillah, I spoke to you before for 2 hours, correct?
Okay.
So I'm not scared of you because I know you're empty.
Okay.
Alhamdulillah, I don't believe baby was inside private room.
That's fine.
Okay.
I don't believe the devil is inside your
head.
I don't believe that the devil lives inside your nose, and therefore you need to wash it. Okay. Do you believe that?
What's more explicit, a nose or a vagina? What's more explicit?
No, wait!
A nose or a vagina?
Where did Allah blow into?
No, wait.
I'm talking to
Allah blow
into. I'm talking to a circus.
Now, come on.
What happened?
Yo, answer me.
First of all, brothers, let me refute that. We don't believe the devil is bigger than the universe.
All right.
We don't believe the devil is bigger than
the
nose. We know the devil can change
about the devil living in your nose?
Wait, I'm speaking about it. We believe the devil can change forms. Understand? But devil can change, but you believe God does not change, and he was inside the woman's private parts. So keep
stay
quiet.
To the topic.
Okay, now
you believe that devil farts, right?
Farts, what you know about? Okay. Alas, anyway. So paper boy, my point, she stopped me. Okay.
Yeah.
And she was talking about women, everything.
Yeah.
She's coming from the angle.
I was there.
Okay. So my point was to her that there is some passage in the Quran as well, mm-hmm. some situation when there is a woman has more right mm-hmm. or. I'm all right because Allah gives everyone he deserves. There is some specific situation, woman is exclusive rights, okay?
Mm-hmm.
Likewise in the Bible. Do you agree with that?
Yeah.
So between me and you, there is no debate. It was between me and her because okay. She's coming from the angle that there's a problem with Quran because some situation, the woman seems like this and that. When in the Bible, clearly, the passage said, Adam was not deceived.
Mm-hmm.
Who was deceived? Eve. And she said, no, Adam was deceived.
Okay.
So how can you defend that?
No, my thing was this.
How was
because when he was talking to her,
yeah.
Then I wanted to interject. He said, no. Then he gave me the phone and tells me to explain.
Yeah.
And then he said, do I want to be involved in this debate? So I stepped forward.
Okay, now
then he said, he was speaking. I was trying to respond. He said, I haven't finished. Then when he finished, what did he do? He ran away.
No, because it's my point.
I was going to make a point to address.
Okay, go
what
on.
He
go make points. Make points.
So, because he was obviously
paper
trying
boy.
To say.
Paper boy, we're not going to say it till tomorrow. I have a class, so make your points, and then I have to go.
Let me respond to him.
Okay.
So now he was trying to say that bring a highlight how Christianity treats the Christian woman.
Why are you looking at me?
I'm just looking all around.
No, that's okay.
So. Because I wanted to ask you a question from a hadith.
No, deal with the point. No. Don't come with the hadith. Deal with the point.
You see?
Deal with
the point. What is the point?
My point
actually,
was
wait.
Because you came here to defend
wait.
Her.
Wait.
No, it's come with different.
If I deal with the point, you deal with my point.
Okay, what's your point? Go on, what's your point?
Okay.
Because I don't like him.
Alright. So now, we go to Sahih Bukhari. And it says, Rifa divorced his wife, whereupon Abdul Rahman married her. Aisha said that the lady came wearing a green veil and complained to her of her husband and showed her a green spot on her skin caused by a beating. It was the habit of ladies to support each other. So when Allah's messenger came, Aisha said, I have not seen any woman suffering as much as the believing woman. Let me say it again. He says, I have not seen any woman suffering as much as the believing woman.
Okay.
So my statement would be, why would Aisha say that the believing woman who is treated so eloquently, why would she say that the believing woman is treated worse than the other woman?
First of all, we know that...
Because that's what her word.
First of all, Aisha...
She said, let me just say it again. I have not seen any woman suffering as much as the believing woman.
Okay, so now, first of all, that's not the Quran or the Sunnah. So she said what she witnessed, okay? And doesn't mean even because Aisha, she saying what she witnessed, okay?
Okay.
And this has been refused by one of the scholars. What was it exactly?
Why you said Aisha was a scholar.
Okay, it doesn't mean a scholar, a prophet of God.
but you're going to give me another
no,
scholar.
No, bro, bro.
But Aisha was a scholar.
Paper boy,
so of course he knows. Because he said he was, it was refuted and he's going to try and bring me a scholar.
No,
but I'm saying Aisha is a scholar too.
No. Aisha, she's not talking about rulings here.
Okay.
Wallah, paper boy, sometimes you get me frustrated.
But if he has knowledge.
Look, it's not going to speak.
Yeah, but I'm explaining.
But let me speak.
I'm going to speak.
I'm asking you to explain it.
All right, go on.
Stop acting for the cameras, bro.
Okay.
That's why, paper boy, I don't want to speak to you because you don't let a person speak. And paper boy, I'm speaking to you. Stop looking to your phone. Okay. Aisha is a scholar.
Okay.
When she gives a ruling. Now, Aisha, she said in the hadith, I never seen Prophet Muhammad doing something who's according to her knowledge. But another company, he saw something else. So when Aisha said something that was according to her knowledge, she's not giving a ruling based upon the Quran and the Sunnah.
That's not what I said though.
What she said? She said Quran Sunnah says mistreat woman. Does it say that?
I'm saying to
no, no, does it say
Quran? You're not addressing my question. I said why
that's what
did
saying.
She say?
I'm saying
yes.
According to her knowledge that was something happening. Was she...
did she see many women?
Yeah,
subjective.
I'm asking, did she see many women?
I'm going to finish here. I'm going to let the brother, because I don't remember the Sheikh mentioned it. He can remember the word. What was exactly he said?
Yeah, so basically, the hadith you're talking about is that a woman came to complain to Aisha.
Yes.
Because basically what happened is that she divorced a man and then she married another one, but then the man was hitting her.
Yes.
So basically, she complained to Aisha to get a divorce.
Okay.
And she came to her and she had bruising.
Yes.
So Aisha said, I haven't seen the believing woman suffer more. Why? Because of the calamities that believing women have gone through. But that doesn't mean that Islam treats them wrong.
Yeah,
why?
See,
no, I explain.
Does that make sense?
No, one second. Because when we said the scholars explain, it means that from the appearance of the text, how do we understand the text? It's not because Aisha said something. Mm-hmm. We're explaining the explanation of that speech. We're not saying Aisha is explaining something and we're explaining something else. We're explaining Aisha's speech.
Yeah, okay.
See? So the scholars have mentioned that from the text, the Quran and the Sunnah tells you to look after your wife.
Yeah.
And the Prophet said,
that was my point.
That's
your wife. No,
bro, I can't find that.
He's explaining.
No, you're being ambiguous on purpose. What do you mean by being?
Strike your wife.
Okay, what do Muslims understand by beat?
Okay.
No, what's it?
You make your statement, I'm going to respond.
When you say strike, people are going to understand that needs to beat someone up. Okay. But you've had conversation with us, and we've explained to you that the word hit is a specific meaning.
Me?
Because
there's no conversation with me.
We had it with the family.
Okay, so you have no idea.
Anyway,
I haven't had a conversation.
Okay, that's fine. So the companions explain that if you hit your wife, then you can't leave any bruising or mark on her body.
So summarize it. Summarize it clearly. So Aisha, she's not saying Prophet Muhammad said to do it or the Quran says to do it. Mm-hmm. She witnessed something which is according to her knowledge. Okay, you understand that?
So you're saying Islam says treat the women very well, but then Aisha's saying all the women,
all the women
she's seen have been mistreated. That
but,
doesn't make sense.
No, it's not.
She can say all the women she's seen have been treated.
Can I ask you one? No, before you ask me, so she's talking about something she saw, okay, but also. She mentioned that the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam take care of the woman. Okay, so now Aisha, she's mentioning something she witnessed, correct?
Okay.
Understand? So my argument was, it's not about what some Muslims are doing. My argument was what is in the Bible. What you just did, you are bringing what Aisha witnessed that some Muslim done or some woman going through hardship. Understand? That is not what Allah said, Prophet Muhammad said. Because Allah said clearly to take care of them. Prophet Muhammad said clearly to take care of them. You understand that? Is that clear?
But then it seems strange that the men are misunderstanding. Because look, for example,
what does
in let me speak first. You respond after. It says, Abu Bakr narrated Aisha. Abu Bakr came towards me and struck me violently with his fist and said, you have detained the people because of your necklace, but I remained motionless as if I was dead, lest I should awake Allah's messenger, although the hit was very painful. So now we're seeing
Who's Abu Bakr? Who's Abu Bakr? Abu Bakr is not our wife.
I know.
Who's Abu Bakr?
Who's Abu Bakr?
You
tell me.
No. The biggest hypocrite. Abu Bakr is her father.
Okay.
So there's not the wife and the husband.
Did I say anything about wife and husband?
No, you said about the wife. You said about a Muslim woman. No, that's how.
I said I've never seen a believing woman mistreated. I never met a husband,
okay, yes,
father,
correct,
son.
Correct.
So now
but it's her father. No, it's her father. You understand? Okay. It's her father.
So he can beat her.
No, I didn't say that. No.
Okay, so what are you saying?
What? Listen carefully.
Once again, he said mistreat. That's kelim. In Arabic, it doesn't say mistreat.
That's what I'm saying.
No. It speaks about calamity, to suffer. It doesn't say mistreated.
It doesn't say mistreated.
That's a lie. And suffer, I explain to you. For example,
he said who was Abu Bakr, your father.
Is that father?
That's not the point I made.
You just lied now.
I just made that point.
No, you lied. It doesn't seem mistreated. It said to suffer.
I'm reading from your own Islamic sources. So your own sources are
that lie. That's English.
This is your own Islamic website.
Bro,
don't blame me if I'm reading from your own sources. My point, we're diverting. My point was this. My point was this. Aisha said she has not seen the believing woman mistreated.
According to her knowledge.
Now, you are arguing that the believing woman should be treated with respect and whatnot.
Yes.
And I'm now giving you another example of Abu Bakr striking her with his fist.
I'll give you an example. Watch this. For example, when the Prophet and his companions migrated to Medina.
Remember, paper boy, regardless how you explain to him, he's not here to listen. So what we're going to explain, because he's not a criteria for our explanation to be valid, he has to accept it. Remember that. So regardless, just go explain it.
So the believing woman, no, once again, there's many...
Because he said I'm not here to listen. But when I tried to explain the Bible, was he listening? So therefore he is exposed as a hypocrite. Because I said it's the Christians who interpret the Bible, not the Muslims. Did he listen to me?
Let me refuse argument. First of all, you can be Catholic Christian, Ikhwa, brothers, Muslims. You can be Catholic, born again Christian, and they will differ concerning the passage. So we'll give you the authority then. Okay. Anyway, go on. What are you going to say?
Yeah, I was saying, so the Hadith mentions that the believing woman, I haven't seen one that suffered the most. That apparent from the text doesn't say, I haven't seen a believing woman being hit the most.
Yeah, being hit.
Then you could say, we're interpolating the text.
I didn't say hit the most. You're mischaracterizing my point.
Once again, I'm saying, then you could say we're introducing our Islamic belief into the text, but we're not. Because even the scholars mentioned that the believing woman, there's many things she goes through that the believing man doesn't go through. For example, when the Prophet migrated to Medina, there were believing women who were married to non-believing men who used to hit them and not look after them properly. So they had to travel from Mecca to Medina, you see? So there's a lot of trials and hardship that believing women have gone through that believing men haven't gone through.
So that's another Muslim men doing it.
So it's not specific to say that I haven't seen a believing woman be mistreated the most, meaning that their husband smacked them up.
That's not what I said.
Yeah, yeah, that's what you said
that's
though.
No, that's not what... You see, you're mischaracterizing
my point.
Mistreatment Where did I say mistreatment?
Okay, what is your point?
My first question was, why did Aisha say she has not seen the believing woman mistreated? So where did I say they've lied upon me to say that I equivocated it with beating?
No, I never said anything with beating.
Then he tried to say about Abu Bakr.
That's her husband. That's her father. Yeah.
I didn't say anything. I just gave an example and said,
that's too explanation.
Therefore, you lie.
No, I didn't lie.
I lied to you, but you quoted a verse about beating your wife.
Okay.
No, I didn't make the point.
That's not my point. My question was, why does she say
Okay, explain it. Do you hear the explanation?
He explained it.
Can you repeat the explanation what he said?
Well, people were talking.
Okay, he said summarize it. Okay, summarize it. No,
because everyone's talking.
Yeah, sure. Some people cut it. It's true. We have to agree with it. Okay, his explanation.
Yes.
When he said that she hasn't seen a Muslim woman suffering a lot, doesn't necessitate they were suffering by a Muslim man. Means, as the brother explained, because I remember we asked one of the mashayikh, one of the teachers, okay? And he sent a voice note. I heard about all of it, so that's why he heard it and he remembered it. That's why I tell him to translate it. So what it means here, that the time of Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, for example, when the Muslim woman became a Muslim, her non-Muslim husband was mistreating her as well. And she was hard for her to travel, okay? Because as you know, that the Muslim woman not allowed to travel for the distance of 3 days, 3 nights by herself, okay? Because we know that when a woman travels herself for 3 days, 3 nights, there's a lot of danger out there, a lot of fox and wolves out there, okay? So she's mentioning from that angle. So what she's talking about, Aisha, she's not talking about Muslim man abusing her and this and that. So I suffering is
based on the scholar, but what's the scholar there?
Do you know why? Do you know why? Because when you read the biographies, which we have the biographies of Prophet Muhammad, the biographies of his companions and the wives, for example,
but one of the scholar there at the time.
The scholar.
So it's a guess.
Prophet Muhammad said to go back to Allah said in the Quran to go back to scholars.
Yes.
Okay. Prophet Muhammad said the scholars are the inheritance of the Prophet. Okay. Allah never said to go back to paper boy.
But how does that scholar know? That's
tell
my question.
For example,
is there a narration?
Okay. Listen, explain it.
And now, for example, we know that there was a companion male.
Yeah.
He loved a companion female.
Okay.
And she didn't want to go back to him whatsoever. Okay. And he was suffering because of her. He was what? Imagine that he was suffering, okay?
Okay.
Now, if the Islam was every woman be suffered, we have this narration when the woman, man was suffering because of her. Not because the woman was suffering. Then Prophet Muhammad came to her and said, look to his situation. Can you go back to him? She said, oh, Messenger of Allah, here another point, brothers and sisters, to show you Prophet Muhammad was a true prophet, he was not a tyrant. Okay? She said to him, oh, Messenger of Allah, do you want to reconcile between us or is it a commandment from Allah to go back to him? He said, no, I just want to reconcile between you two. She said, I don't like him, I don't want to go back to him. Prophet Muhammad said, this is your choice. He didn't force her. He didn't say, what? You woman, reject my statement. No, he said, this is your choice. Okay? So there's many narration when the Muslim woman, the Aisha's biography, Fatima's biography, Zainab's biography, Umm Kulthum's biography, they were respected, treated nicely by the companions, taking care of them. So there is many circumstances, many situations when the believer woman was treated respectfully, but doesn't mean every woman.
Yes, okay, but
do you understand
now he's given this quote, but in this hadith where the woman was beaten,
let me
ask you a question. Did
Muhammad
criticize the husband for beating her
Prophet
in that situation?
Prophet did, yes. Prophet said, he said, this hadith has, that's a problem with paper boy and many Christians. Christian missionaries, they don't
bring
know.
Me the evidence then. That's all I'm asking for, the evidence.
First of all,
yes.
When you read the hadith, sometimes the hadith doesn't mention everything,
right.
So you have to go to other hadith, okay? It's finished. Prophet Muhammad said clearly.
Yeah, I agree, that's fine. But yeah, I want to see it, that's all.
If you let me speak, I'm going to speak.
I want to see the evidence.
I'm going to say Prophet Muhammad said.
I want to see the evidence, that's all.
What evidence is
why is it he brings out the Bible and then...
Let I don't know all the time. Baby boy,
let me... He has it, man.
No, okay. I have it here. Okay, Prophet Muhammad said, you're not allowed to harm your wife. You're not allowed to
that man.
No, Prophet said it to everyone. No man.
But I said,
specific.
No, I'm saying this situation where the man was beating his wife.
Okay, no.
Show me where Muhammad criticized.
Show me who said he didn't. Show me who said he didn't.
You've got the hadith. He said
he didn't.
No, wait.
Because I told you again.
So the biggest. I've got hadith.
Does the hadith say he didn't?
Shall we?
No, that's the hadith say he didn't.
What? Does it? Shall we read the hadith?
No, that's the
shall
hadith that said he didn't.
Shall we read the hadith?
That's what I don't speak person.
Read the hadith. All right. No, because I've asked for evidence.
How many people have said that?
Half an hour.
I want to see it. I asked, did he criticize? Because his point was that there was a situation where the husband or whatever didn't want to go back to the wife or the wife. And he said, no, I want you to, right?
He said, I want you to? He said, just a reconciliation.
Yeah, exactly.
Okay, no.
Right, so I'm saying, if he was that so upstanding, as you just pointed out in that scenario,
yes.
Where in the scenario where the husband is physically beating his wife, I want to see where he also criticized the husband and said, why did you do that?
Okay, the narration, I have to get to other narrations, but we know Prophet Muhammad clearly said, do not harm your wives. Clearly said that.
Did he say after this happened or before? That's what I'm asking.
Before, all the time.
When did he say it?
The Quran said it as well.
When did this happen? That's my point. Because he has
to... Prophet said all the time. In order for you to say, was abrogated...
But the Quran revealed over 23 years.
So yeah,
this that's what I'm asking.
No, the verse was from the Madaniya verse.
Okay.
The Madani. Prophet Muhammad, Allah said, and clearly, that take care of your wives. Look after them. Okay? And we know Allah Prophet said, la dara wala dirar. You're not allowed to harm yourself or harm the others. Now we keep talking about Islam. No, wait, 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 wait.
But
no,
you haven't answered the question of where did he criticize the man?
I'm not gonna answer.
Where did he criticize? No.
Baby boy, can I speak? Wallahi, remember, this is the last time I'm gonna speak to this guy.
No, I'm gonna let you finish my point.
No. Do you have a problem? No, wait.
He hasn't answered my question.
Okay, I'm gonna answer. Do you have a problem with harming women?
Do I have a problem?
Yeah.
Oh, it's a lot of violence.
Do you have a problem with harming women?
In what sense?
Do you have a problem with harming women?
In what sense?
Beating innocence.
Ah, well, it's
I'm
not,
asking you,
you
do have
beat a woman, no.
That should be. So when God said to Moses to kill every woman, is that okay? Is that Jesus? Is that Jesus? Is that Jesus?
Well, because what we believe is
I ask, who's that Jesus?
Now let me explain. Okay, believe God. God owns every soul. So if God takes a life, it's up to him. Now, prophets are an instrument of God. They speak on behalf of God and they can act on behalf of God. So if God commands something, for example, death, then God is delivering judgment. So we cannot go against what God says.
Okay, so no problem. So now when you talk about the verse, for the sake of argument, when Allah said to Prophet Muhammad in the Quran to discipline our wives, do you have a problem with it?
To beat your wife?
No, it doesn't say beat. For the sake of argument, beat your wife, do you have a problem with it?
Because there's a difference. Now, God, I said God owns every soul.
You ask a question.
I'm answering.
Do you have a problem with it?
No, I said, he asked me about people being killed, because we know during the flood, men, women, children.
I ask you that. Do you have a problem with
it? He doesn't let me answer. I'm answering in my own way.
No, that's why I don't speak to paper.
You see, they don't want me to answer. I'm saying to you, when it comes to death, do I agree with the beating in
Look, Ikhwa, he never had my question. What was my question?
You were asking about the verse where it says to, I mean, what you don't like calling it beating, I call it beating women.
What was my question?
You said, if I believe, if God orders something,
My question was, my question was to you, clearly, you said to me, if God said to do something to a prophet, and the prophet does it, you have no problem with it.
I said, if God is a...
Like
I'm repeating what I said.
Go on.
I said, God owns souls.
Does he own all bodies?
So when he...
No, does he own all bodies?
He owns all bodies.
Because when he hits someone's body, God owns it.
So now you agree...
Then you don't have a problem. You shouldn't have a problem. For argument's sake, if God says hit your wife, and God owns all bodies, is that right?
If God says...
Silence. Okay, answer.
It's all right. You see, these guys, they're honest.
You've been learning from this guy too much. I'm speaking and you're currently interrupting me.
Go on.
So, now, we were saying, if God instructs you to be a wife,
Let him talk.
Does God own bodies?
Yes.
We will say yes, he does.
Okay, so now you said, because God owns souls, so it's okay for, remember, in Old Testament, Moses killed the woman, they haven't done nothing. So woman, Masakin, woman, you know, woman walking, God said, go to Moses, go kill them. Okay? So he said, the reason I believe in it, he has no problem to say it, and no one will criticize him because he's not Muslim. If he was a Muslim, he would be called terrorist.
No.
He says, because we as Christians do not follow this.
This was an order for about 3, 4, 5 thousand.
Anyway, my point here is, so you said God owns souls, yeah? So I said to you, God owns a body, you said yes. What about ask you, yeah? So now when God said beat the wife, as you claim, because not like that at all. I explained it last week to Fan. When God said hit the beat the wife, then our argument would be, you agree with us, God on the body. So God said it's okay then.
So I'm not saying I agree with what you're saying.
No, that's your criteria, double standard.
No.
Double standard.
This is false equivocation because I said when people die, for example, the floods, men, women and children were killed. So unless you're going to criticize Allah for allowing women and children to die during the flood.
But you don't. We're talking about you.
But are you criticizing?
No, we're saying.
But he's the one who said about shaving women's hair.
No. Wait. But of course, we don't believe God will tell you to kill a woman, because Prophet Muhammad said clearly, do not kill a woman in the world. But no, wait. So we have a Christian here who tried to talk about Aisha. She said, as some Muslim woman suffered and he misunderstood it, okay? And he has no problem for a woman being slaughtered alive for a sin they never done. Then he tried to make it justified by the flooding. No. The flooding again, a woman or a man committing a sin, doesn't look, first of all,
the children
Who said they were children?
So we have a whole nation.
I didn't ask you now.
Imagine if I say London was flooded and there's no children.
Okay,
killed.
No.
That's shambles.
I didn't say that.
So where are the children?
No, I'm asking you.
You asked me first and didn't answer.
Paper boy, I'm just asking you.
Yes.
In the Bible, clearly says kill a woman.
Okay.
Correct? Does it say in the Quran the flooding there was children?
So you're saying that?
No, I'm asking you. No, answer my question.
I'm asking you, was there children?
Paper boy, no.
No,
paper boy. Does it say in the Bible?
No.
Paper boy.
You see how he debates.
Yeah. Does it say kill a woman? Paper boy. Does it say kill a woman?
Was children
there? No, paper boy. Listen. Does in the Bible says kill a woman?
Was children there? I've already answered this before.
Okay, that's kill a woman. Okay.
I've answered this
now,
already.
That's in the Quran or the Bible says the children were there.
So
I'm asking you, say yes or no.
I'm asking you.
Where's the joke? I haven't read it.
He's trying to say there's no children.
I didn't say that. I haven't read it.
If there's no children, I'm asking you.
I haven't read it.
Do you think there was children?
Doesn't say
logic dictates if Sodom and Gomorrah was destroyed, it's like me saying London is destroyed and there's no women or children that's destroyed. If that's your argument, are you saying that?
Can logic dictate that God...
Are you saying there's no children?
Wait. Can logic dictate...
Because that's Sam's logic. Two whole cities destroyed and no children.
How do you say that?
So why are you bringing up the point?
Bro, because you are saying... in the okay. Watch this, yeah?
Yeah, watch.
Ikhwa, another point. You said, where the Prophet Muhammad told of the person, doesn't say that. So now, when I ask you the question, I said to you, maybe Prophet Muhammad said it, but it's not there. And because why? We know Prophet Muhammad, Ikhwa, Allahu Akbar. We're going to conclude with this. Khitam Muhammad.
Don't run away.
You can run away now.
Don't run away.
Okay, now I want to finish it.
Right.
You said, I want to remind you, step by step, be honest.
Okay.
You said to me, in the hadith doesn't say Prophet Muhammad told of the person, okay? I said to you about Prophet Muhammad clearly said, do not harm your wives, okay? Now, I said to you, does it say in the Bible or the Quran, when the flooding happened, there were children? Doesn't say that at all, doesn't say that, you agree? Doesn't say, but you say logic dictates, because our nation, it must be children there as well. Which one is more logical? Which will have a clear text when the Prophet Muhammad said, do not harm your wife, therefore Prophet Muhammad will tell him off. Even though it's not there, but we know, generally speaking, Prophet Muhammad said clearly, do not harm your wives. Finish, brother.
Finish.